So we are in the last and final module, final topic of e-Shikshana series for this subject, which is electrical services and illumination. Today in module 5, subheading 2, we are going to talk about preparation of electrical layout. So we'll be talking about electrical layout design number 1 and load estimation for the same as number 2. Though the syllabus wants us to know electrical layout design for a residence, so before I get into an actual residence, a full scale residence, I would want to make a couple of things clear here, right? So we have studied after electricity getting generated, transmitted and distributed, if this is our site, we have some of these electrical poles going outside our house. So we tap in, the government gives a supply, and we have a metering device. It comes to something else in our house, and that is where we tap power for all other appliances inside the house. So I just wanted to refresh your memory on, so if this is the electric poles that is happening outside our houses or plots, this is our electrical, the meter which is used to bill for our consumption by the government. After this, till here is where it is the government's responsibility, right? So after this, whatever happens, it is based on the individual plot owner's responsibility. So from here, what happens is, so we take it to something called as DB. So if some of you could remember, DB is nothing but a distribution board. So it can be of various sizes, like we have discussed in our second chapter and some of it in third chapter. It can be of various sizes, and there can be a number of distribution boards, right? The one which you usually must have seen, or the ones which most of us must be seeing in our house, will have something of this size with the press button in the bottom, with some of the panel door made of fiber, transparent fiber, and some of it can be opaque. So in this you have series of circuit breakers, right? So depending upon the requirements, we have so many of them happening next to each other, and some of them can just be dummies as well. Remember when we studied about this in our third module? So this will be on, this will be off. Right. So likewise, when you have, so this, I'll just indicate a door here with the opening. So for as a facility, the area of the facility and the load capacity increases, so we will have a number of distribution boards. Sometimes depending upon the area, we will have more than one in a particular floor. Some of them, it can be just one per floor. Sometimes it can be one for a couple of floors. So that all depends upon the requirement that we have, and based on the standard and the strategies of the electrical engineer. So now considering this, we are going to have a series of provisions for circuit breakers. So what I'm drawing here is your distribution board. These are the provisions for the circuit breakers. And so what happens is, from the meter, which is the government supply, we are going to take it till here, and from here it is going to get distributed to various other spaces inside our house. So the strategies are numerous. Again, there are places, let's say any house would have a series of lights located in them, appliances like fans, air conditioning systems, and kitchen appliances, water heater, geysers, and so many sockets. And some of these days we have UPS powered, battery powered systems, right? So there are so many of them. If you have to classify them, let's say all the lights are going to be taken care by one set of circuit breakers. So in such case, I will say all the lights across my house is going to, all the lights across the floors in the house is going to be taken care by this particular provision, which is made of series of circuit breakers. The moment, and of course there will be a bigger one, master switch. The moment you switch that off, the lighting for the entire house goes off, right? This is one way of strategizing. I'm not saying this is the only way. There are several ways of doing it, but this is one among the many ways. So number two, let me say all my raw power, which is actually the major sockets, are taken care by this DB, right? So that is raw power DB. Sometimes we can say this is our battery powered DB for UPS. This can be our fans and other appliances DB, right? There are several ways of doing it. Sometimes this can be, let's say, ground floor DB. This can be first floor DB. This can be just 6 amps or the higher amps DB, 16 amps DB. So there are several ways of strategizing and classifying these DBs, right? So this is where, depending upon the location of this DB in a house, this is one major equipment which is going to supply power to all the spaces that we want in a house, right from the one which is right outside your door on the balcony, or to the one which is in your landscape, or to the one which is in your terrace, or to the one which is in your backyard, or to the one which is used for the maintenance in your setback area, right? So this DB is the central power component or element or space which is going to supply power to all other spaces. So this DB is to be understood something as a battery. If in case of DC power, this is the battery which is going to give power, distribute power and take it back so that it makes a circuit complete. So remember this. And now from here, I will again show you a quick, we will start this electrical layout with a smaller plan so that we get into the basics of it. And then once when we get to know the basics, it is just a matter of increasing the scale for the same set of work. It is just going to be repetitive work. So we will start with the smaller room, right? So with the tiny piece of introduction to DB, a metering panel, to the DB, to various other locations where we tap the current from, I will draw a simple square that we start understanding how to make an electrical layout. So this is, let's say this is a penthouse located in the top of an apartment. So it has reached several floors, and finally we are in the, let's say, 10th floor, and we have this entire terrace happening. Right. So we have already seen some of it in our lighting layout, which is module 4. Over here, we will be repeating some of it because we also have lights coming over here. So let's say we are going to have a light. So I'm not going to use the actual conventions. I'm going to use alphabet so that we get better with the explanations. So that we can understand the explanation easily. So, but I'll also display or show you the conventions from NBC at some of the slides where you can relate to each of this, right? So I am going to have a light, because as soon as we enter, once when we reach, we would need a light. and the light has to be controlled from outside. So I'm going to put a switch which can control the light. So let me connect it then and there, let it be, right? So now, is it one depending upon the area? We can have a couple of lights as well. So let it be here. We will think about if we have, if this is going to require a separate switch or it can function with the same control. So we have two lights outside. Okay. Now as we enter, we would again need a couple of switches which can control at least one light as we enter. This is all the design aspect of it. We will not be spending much time or even think about if it is right or wrong. So we need a switch as soon as we enter so that the entire interior indoor space gets lit. So let us start with, we are going to have a light here which is initially going to light up the space, and this is the switch of that. So let us for now connect this switch also, this light also to that switch. So these two are taken care by this. Now as soon as we enter, we have a light happening here which is getting controlled with the switch, right? So now let us say we will have another light here for which the switch control depending upon the requirement can be anywhere. So let us control this. Now that this being a room, let's say we are going to have a couple of fans, right? The switches for this fan can depend upon the activity. So if it is a defined and designed space, and if we know that the cot is going to come somewhere here, or this is where the living seating space is going to come, we can probably give a switch next to that. So imagine, let's not imagine this as a cot, let us imagine this as the TV space, and we're going to have seating. Right, this is the TV cabinet. Right, so let me give a switch here which can control this fan, and depending upon the activity, let's say we will put a workstation here or some other activity happening there, and we will connect, we will give a switch here to control this fan. And so right now the both the fans that we have and all 1, 2, 3, 4 lights that we have is connected. And let us extend this further by a bit, where I'm going to have a toilet and the next off I'm going to have a kitchen, right? So this space is going to be our kitchenette, a small pantry kind of a space, and this is where we are going to have the toilet. Right, so let us say this is going to be the kitchen counter and this is going to be your washroom, right? So we know we are definitely going to need a light in here, so let me put a light and the switch of switch control for that preferably have to be outside. So I will just locate a switch and connect it. And for the kitchen, let me again put up a light here, and somewhere before even we enter the kitchen, I'll put up a switch control. And so right now all the lights that we have and the fans we have is connected, but what we have left, so we started with lights, we went to fan. What is being left out is we drew a TV but it is not connected, so the appliances are not connected yet, right? So we will have to think about the appliances as well. So we have a TV. How does a TV get its power from? So we need to have a socket. I will write it as SO. So that TV is having a socket. Without getting into what is the capacity of a socket, I'm just going to make sure all our appliances are connected. So this ideally has to be inside. Sorry for this. So the TV is connected now, right? what else can we think of? So in kitchen, let us imagine a fridge here, refrigerator. So this would need a socket. Induction top would need a socket. Microwave oven would need a socket. What else can you think of? If at all, depending upon the requirement, if you're going to have an air conditioning system, that is going to require a socket. What else? If at all we are going to, yes, these days, so how do you charge your mobile? So all of these appliances are connected. So how do you plug in something which you have, you have it in a mobile? It is not stationed like a TV, so you have to keep moving on a regular basis. So it is also required that we give some additional sockets without getting it connected to any appliances, so that we have the liberty to connect the appliance that we have at hand, right? So that is when we give extra sockets, right? So sometimes, okay, your microwave oven is connected, induction top is connected, but there is a mixer which you would probably need to operate. So where is the socket for that? So that is why we should always have to think about a couple of more extra sockets, right? But again, don't flood the entire house with so much of sockets. But okay, let's say we have covered many of them and we have given a couple of more sockets, and in some cases the connection probably makes it ugly, so we will have to plan these on which side it is going to come, at what height is going to come is not discussed here. So again, if I have to get into that aspect, if you have to take this example, where for the AC, I have just mentioned socket. At the same time, for the TV, we again have mentioned socket. At the same time, for the refrigerator, we have again mentioned socket. At the same time, we have mentioned for a mixer, grinder, or your induction, it's socket. And imagine we have an exhaust fan here, which would again require a socket. Of course, I told you the capacity of these in terms of the amp power current it is going to give plays a major criteria in determining the watt amp of the socket. But what is also missing is, when I talk about this, the socket for AC is not going to be at the same level. So AC is going to happen at say 300, 400 mm from the ceiling. So the socket for that have to be somewhere here, right? Not somewhere here. At the same time, similarly, when you have your exhaust fan, your socket has to be somewhere there so that it can be plugged in. Whereas when you talk about a TV, it is going to be at a much lower height, right? So where do you capture the height? So similarly, when you have something in the kitchen counter, it is going to be of a different height. So the idea of an electrical layout is not to capture the size of these. So that is where we specify the height of all this in your interior panel. Sometimes when you're doing an interior, when you have a huge TV cabinet, the interior designer would definitely mind some of these sockets seen outside the cabinet, or the wires protruding out. So this has to be neatly designed, capturing all those sockets. At the same time, even you have to even dress up the wire in such a fashion that the cabinet covers up all the wires and there is nothing which is seen out, right? And so what I'm trying to say here is, the height factor of where it has to be located is never captured in an electrical layout. So that means whenever I mention something, if a wall has, let's say this wall is, look at this particular example. We have a series of sockets, 1, 2, 3 sockets, one exhaust fan, one light happening. So when you have to represent it that way, doesn't mean that all of them are going to happen like one socket, one light, one socket, one light, one socket. It is not that way. It is just an indication that wall is going to have these many requirements in terms of sockets, appliances, lights, fans, etc. So it is again, there will be a wiring layout and connection layout which will tell which wire is going to be connected together, and they even talk about modules. So start observing in your house, when you have one socket and you have three switches, it is called as a 3 switch module. When you have 5 switches, it is called as 5 switches module. I'm not very sure about the module aspect of it, but they come in a particular size standard. So depending upon how many, so now we know we need 3 sockets. And forget this light, because the light switch is going to be here. We need 3 sockets minimum, and one extra 4 sockets, and one for the exhaust fan. So we will need something like this. We are going to need something like this. We need 4 sockets. So whenever there is a socket, it automatically needs a switch. Are you going to flood the entire wall with continuous sockets and switches? No. So can you plan it accordingly, where you can have one here, or a couple of them here, so that it doesn't, it is not seen completely from the entrance, right? There are so many strategies of making this happen. So in an electrical layout, we have to be understanding it superficially, that when it means this wall is continuously having A, B, C, S, O, L, F, doesn't mean that it is happening in that order. It is just that this particular space is going to require these many of appliances and socket requirements. That's about it, right? So when I talk about this reserve sockets, we should also be worried about the raw power sockets. So some of them, we will discuss about this vacuum cleaners, and also they will move at this particular height, especially your vacuum cleaner. So you can't usually borrow it from this height, because we are wasting the cable. And so vacuum cleaners and all will have power sockets located at 1 foot above the finished floor level, right? There are so many of it. So from the exhaust fan, which is happening at the ceiling level, to the vacuum cleaner, which is again happening very much close to your floor level. At the same time, you can't completely lower it, because while mopping and cleaning, there is a possibility that water would enter inside. So there are so many factors that needs to be considered while designing these. So as an architect, we will probably have to know all this, like what are the appliances that we are going to have. In fact, our focus majorly gets into this, how to hide all this sometimes, depending upon what is needed. Sometimes if you are designing a showroom or an apparel store where we have exposed wires, exposed conduits, so probably the strategy would be different. But ideally, it is our duty to capture all that is needed. In other words, we should not be missing anything. So later somebody comes and says, we should have had something there, that should have been there, it is missing. Idea is not to miss anything and keep the client informed about this is what is required. And then we have to work in, we have to sync ourselves with the electrical engineer who will come up with the, who will understand the requirements and come up with this aspect of it, and he will tell us how much switches and wires are sockets are going to be needed, and you again capture his ideas or the technical aspect of it, so that we decide where we can locate all that and what height from the counter. Are you going to locate it right below the counter, because some of the work desk have their sockets on the table. If you have seen a conference table, the sockets are on the table. By the press of a button, it will pop up. So you connect your laptops, and once when the meeting gets over, we again push it back so that the table remains without any additional wires seen. It is properly flushed. So there are several ways of planning, but of course it has to be coordinated very well with the electrical consultants and other consultants involved, right? So if this is clear, we will move on to the residential plan, where I'm just going to repeat the same with a set of conventions from NBC. Another thing which is not to be forgotten, and it's important here, is I have connected this switch to these two lights. Similarly, everything except the sockets, all the switches are connected to the lights. Remember, I told you about the DB, distribution box or board or the panel, distribution panel, in the previous diagram where we spoke about the electrical poles and all that. So this is the guy who is getting us all this, who is energizing the entire terrace and the penthouse, right? So whatever said and done, all this definitely is going to have or already having a relationship with this. So what we usually do is, even though it is understood that it has to be connected to our DB, there is something called a home run, right? We will discuss about this in the next thing. But we have to end all this with one arrow like this, with whatever appliance that we connect, from exhaust fan to lights to whatever we have, right? So what is this line which is going from each of these appliances, at least in terms of lights and fans? We will discuss in the next diagram, where I actually take you to an electrical layout for a residence, and there where I'll explain you more about the home run, right? Moving on to the residence plan